Today, we are going to fix Msvcp140.dll missing problem. Before moving on to the video, don't forget to leave a like. The first solution is to download DirectX and Visual C++. These two programs are Microsoft DLL libraries. By downloading these programs, we will complete the missing DLL file. To download programs, we open our browser. You can search for DirectX download to go to the Microsoft website. If you prefer not to bother with this, I will put a link in the description where you can open the Microsoft website. Once we're on the site, we select our language and click on download. We have downloaded DirectX. The same applies to Visual C++. You can search for Visual C++ and download it from Microsoft's site. If you also prefer not to go through this process, you can check the description. After opening the Microsoft website, we scroll down. Here, there is one important thing we need to pay attention. We need to know our system's bit. If you don't already know this, click on the Windows icon and then click on System. From there, you can find out your system type, whether it's 64-bit or 32-bit. Now we know our bit, we can proceed to download Visual C++. If our system is 64-bit, we download the x64 version. If it is 32, we download the x86 version. We have downloaded our programs. Now, let's move on to the installation process. We click on the setup file for DirectX and then tick I accept the agreement. Click on Next to proceed. If you don't want to download Bing, untick Install the Bing bar and then click on Next. We have installed DirectX. Now, let's proceed to Visual C++. Click on Run and Continue. Here, we should see the options Repair or Install. Click on either Repair or Install and proceed. The installation is complete. After doing this, you need to restart your computer. Once your computer has restarted, you can check if the problem is solved or not. If the problem persists, we will move on to the second solution. The second solution is to manually place the missing DLL file into our system files. To do this, we need to have the missing DLL file. To download this DLL, we open our browser. Then, we search for msvcp140.download. In the description, there will be a download link for this DLL file. After opening the website, we scroll down. As mentioned here, if our computer is 64-bit, we need to download both the DLL files for 32-bit and 64-bit. First, let's download the 32-bit one. We have downloaded the DLL. Now, we will place into our system files. To do this, click on Disk PC. Then, open Local Disk C. After that, we open the Windows folder. Now, locate the sys464 folder. After that, we will place the DLL file into this folder. If your system is 32-bit, you need to place this file in system32. We copy the DLL and paste it inside sys464. We click Replace the file in the destination. Then, click Continue to proceed. Here, I am getting file in use warning because I am recording a video. You may receive a destination folder access denied warning. I will put a solution to this problem in the cards section. You can watch that video to resolve your issue. We have placed the first DLL. Now, let's place 64-bit DLL into our system files. You don't need to do this if your system is 32-bit. We open the website again and this time download the 64-bit version. Then, follow the same steps to open the Windows folder. The folder where we need to put the DLL this time is system32. Copy the DLL and paste it into the system32 folder. As I mentioned before, I am unable to perform this step due to video recording. Similar to previous folder, you might receive a destination folder access denied warning here as well. We have placed the missing DLLs into our system files. Now, you can check if the problem is solved or not. We have come to the end of the video. I hope one of these solutions fixed your problem. If the video helped you, don't forget to like the video. You can also subscribe to my channel to support me. Take care and see you in the next video.